as we celebrate our 4 months of the Adams Season Management, 4th annual assignment, as we anticipate the coming of Christ and history of Christmas. But as we get on this 4th Sunday, we also want to anticipate this coming to our lives, to the present, to the Eucharist, to His Word. So we begin now, and we can follow under the Son and the Holy Spirit. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Lord of Father, and the Holy Spirit be with all of you. My sisters and brothers, and let's get ourselves ready once again. We pause and pray God in your service. So get ourselves ready to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Forth with these things, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we too whom we have come to Christ, your Son, was made known by the messenger of angel, many by his passing cross be brought to glory and his resurrection. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. I'm going to go to the next slide. Great, next level, I've always said, I'm going to start reading this right now. What separates Mary from us is that Mary sometimes was favored by God in a special way. She had God's grace given to her just continue to be a part of her life. And so we're here, friend. Probably uncomfortable. Rather than be afraid, as the angel said. Because she didn't know for sure what the outcome would be. Yes, she didn't betray the Joseph, and things were sort of the plans were all set in place, and everything would be just fine. And all of a sudden, we saw a rock there. And she said, see it's coming. I want to explain that to Joseph. But the whole purpose of that particular gospel reading is for us to listen to it and to hear it. And what we do, we hear number one, that anything is possible for God. Number two, that Mary provided in a sense what David was looking for in that first reading from the book of Samuel. David was comfortable in his own palace. He wanted to do something for the Lord. He wanted to build a temple. God said, no, that's not up to you. But then the next day, David had that desire, that was his desire to do that. But what Mary understood it. That new temple was that going to be absolutely important. Because she would, as the old temple held the presence of God, and that God seemed to always overshadow that tent experience of the temple. And somehow God would, in a sense, overshadow her. The Holy Spirit would come down upon her. So that without doubt, God. Child that's going to be born is truly divine and not human. What is that for us? The right perception. I want that one particular gospel reading that says it all. So the challenge for us, I think, is God does ask us sometimes the impossible, and sometimes we don't always understand it. And yet God asks us, and the time we hear it. It's not that we fear, but that we're called to trust. We're called to love. We're called to a deeper relationship than what we might have had before. Does it take that very much? Does it take Mary, I think? But nevertheless, she knew from her understanding of God working in the lives of her people. And God, number one, knows, never met them. Always a part of their lives, and that he will continue to be a part of her life. And so she was able to trust. And also, anything that's attached to all of us on this fourth Sunday, Jesus has come into the world, he has conquered the world, he has conquered every series of our lives. Do we believe that? I hope so. If we truly believe that, no matter what comes our way, sickness, disease, unemployment, tragedies, struggles, crosses, we're called to trust. And when we trust, all things are possible with God. And somehow God always is the one that's victorious. Yeah, there was a thing that Professor Fisk that he said, I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth. All things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sins, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scripture. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and the kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who is spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. Yes. now we're placing prayers for the city for our Father. Be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the awesome Lord our God. If you're right, God, for being our salvation always and the way to you, Jesus. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God, we trust thy Lord. For all of the oracles and the prophets foretold, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all time. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when I came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalt him in praise. And so, with angels and archangels, and with all the divinities, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing with him in your glory and say, God, we should be in thank God. Holy Lord, in all your spirit and life to give you praise. The three Son of our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, we give life to all things and make them holy. You never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from rising the sun to its setting, a true sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts which we have brought to you for God's praise, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and his command which celebrate these mysteries. For the mighty Christ, as he was before, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread. Gave it to his disciples, said, I take this all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be your own for you. Way of supper with him, and he took the chalice from us and gave you thanks and said the blessing. Gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. And do this in memory of you. And this for your faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the fifth and passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving as holy and living sacrifice. Look with faith upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim of his death, you will reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May you make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect. Especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, with St. Peter, and with all of them, by whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation with our Lord advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. We plead from firm and faith and charity, returning to the covenant with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, God, our Bishop, the Lord, and Bishop, all the clergy, the entire people, your being for your own. Blessed grace to take your prayer so that this family will be summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children, scattered throughout the world. With all of our departed brothers and sisters, and all who please that you have been passing from this life, give thanks and witness to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, who will be so in the world all that is good. through him and with him and in him, we got the way from it. The unity of the Holy Spirit will go in our spirits forever and past ever. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil race against these families. And by all your mercy, when they've already freed from sin and saved from all distress, as we wait to bless and hope in the coming of our Savior in Jesus Christ. The Lord Jesus Christ, who said, your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Let the blessing, great faith in your church, and grace in your God, peace and unity in accordance with your will, live and reign forever and ever. And peace to the Lord be with all of you. Thank you. My brothers and sisters, I am the Book of Lamb of God, beholding the big place that is the world of blessing of those who are called in the Supper of the Lamb. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.